Hey, this is Gabe Weaver. I'm the senior product manager for the project management group within the plan stage, talking to you today about what we're going to be working on for 14.6. We have split out our release planning in the plan stage to product groups, and I've kind of revamped the project management template a little bit, starting at sort of a high level in terms of strategic context that this release is tying to. We have some FY22 product investment themes of adoption through usability and GitLab hosted first, quarterly R&D themes of improving product performance and driving ARR, and that has been decomposed down into OKRs for the project management group for this quarter, where we want to, in our first objective, provide the next generation planning object that's usable, performant, and scales with our customers. KRs we're going after is a minimum of 3 paid customers that are early adopters of tasks, which is a new issue type that will eventually, when product planning gets to it, become a child of an issue. For now, it'll just be related. The new work item detail view, which we've been working on, can be accessed via GitLab.com project and used for self-directed usability tests. And the third KR around this objective is to improve the user task success and satisfaction scores for the process of creating children of user stories by a minimum of 40% by the end of the quarter. Second objective is geared towards the improving the usability, reliability, and performance of planned project management surface area, which ties directly back into the product performance. If I didn't mention before, this first driver ties into both these. Eventually, it'll be more ARR. Right now, it's product performance and usability. And within this second objective, we want to reduce the P95 response time for project issues controller. So this is the issue search view and the list view itself, dropping that down from 2.7 seconds to 2 seconds. We want to resolve 10 security issues and also resolve 10 low-hanging UX debt issues. So in terms of our capacity, we're still a little bit low because of our team back-end engineers being loaned over to the Workspaces initiative. So we're kind of underplanning our current release to account for that. And making sure we leave some room for carryover there. And how this ties into specifically what we want to cover in this release in terms of what we're going to be working on, there's a couple different themes. One is this work items, which we've talked about. Tasks is kind of the, how we're MVCing our way there. And this other theme is improving product experience. And this is where we want to resolve some of those UX debt issues. And then a third theme of quality where we want to actually resolve 3 of the 4 security issues. So let's talk about tasks and work items for a bit. Tasks at a high level, we started with features, realized that we were having a hard time iterating on that and kind of making sure that we could pressure test some of the new things that we're building in terms of WebSockets, the new work item detail view, and trying to decouple some of that stuff apart so we can iterate faster. So the overarching goal for tasks is to be this area within the issue where you can click on a task to open up the detail view of the task, which is actually going to be the new work item detail view, and we can iterate on that. We're trying to sidestep a lot of the legacy stuff and get focused on working on that new work item detail and making it a user be able to access it. So the first thing that we're going to be doing in this release is exposing a button to convert a markdown checklist item task to a work item or an issue, more or less. And then we want to surface additional metadata from the work items rendered in GitLab Flavor Markdown and some other stuff. So very simply, this is applicable to all issues that are referenced. Anytime you reference an issue in your text, you basically just render out this pound sign with the issue ID. And the first thing that we're going to be doing to work towards tasks is making it so that if you append a plus to it, it will show the full title. So whenever any referenced issue is dropped into a comment or discussion, you can now see the full title instead of having to hover on the tooltip. So small usability win. It's a great first step to get us towards the longer goal of being able to view tasks within descriptions and comments. So this is what we're going to be working on first, which is sort of a globally optimal usability improvement. So once this is there, we're next going to iterate on to surfacing additional metadata information directly within reference issues in GitLab Flavor Markdown. We're still kind of running a couple surveys to finalize the UX here, but it'll be something along the lines of just showing a task icon and maybe the issue type along with the title itself, which we rendered in the previous MVC. So once this is happening, and this is going to be applicable to all issues, not just tasks, it'll be something anytime you see it, you'll be able to see this additional context and metadata without having to open the issue, which is great for usability. We're then going to go through and open and add the ability to convert one of these markdown checklist tasks to an actual task issue type. As you see in this design, it's been coupled with a little drag and drop indicator. We're actually going to be supporting the ability to reorder these within the description editor in another issue, which I'll talk about in a second. But this is just going to be adding this little icon right here to the left of the checkbox to be able to convert this into an issue of type task, which will automatically create a link here. And then once that's established, if you check the checkbox, it closes the issue. If you uncheck it, it exposes it. So I don't know how far we're gonna get with this particular bit. We're right now for this release and this theme, we're setting this basically surfacing the title and the initial metadata as hard goals with the actual ability to create a task coming as a stretch goal for this theme. On to usability, one of the things that is really annoying is when you do add mention everyone, we don't show any notifications or warnings or help the user understand the impact that they're going to be having when they add mention all. So this is just a small thing that we're going to be doing whenever you add or add mention somebody in all. We're going to be showing this nice little UI notification down here and the impact of the people, how many people you're going to be mentioning if you actually do use the all. So hopefully people will read this before they click comment. This is the smallest thing we can do before we add some sort of forced secondary modal confirmation or something like that. So we're going to see if this has the desirable impacts without kind of impeding or adding additional clicks to the user. The other thing that we're going to be working on, and actually not we had scheduled this, but Phil Hughes was nice enough and wanted to pick this up, is a copy to clipboard button next to every code block in Markdown. So where you have code blocks in your Markdown, being able to click a copy button there, which will copy it to your clipboard so you can paste it into your favorite text editor. Really thankful to Phil for picking this up, and we're excited to see it. These are two usability things that we're targeting as hard goals. And the third that's a stretch is what I mentioned earlier, being able to drag around tasks lists. So this is a pretty well voted issue in and of itself. And it's simply the ability to drag and drop checklist items or anything that is in a unordered or ordered list within Markdown into different orders. So as you can kind of see here, you can start to build out maybe what would be your release plan, convert things into your different tasks. And then later on, this sort of sets up the stage for product planning to come in and add parenting and revamp the linked issues, which is in our current issue view. So those are kind of the two main themes. And then our third, we have security, which I'm not going to go through, but we have identified three security issues we want to resolve. And then the kind of fourth thing that Holly's going to be working on this month is capturing the baseline for the current task workflow in GitLab. So this is a score we're going to be using as a baseline score for our OKR to measure progress against our key results for the new task workflow to make sure that we are improving it by 40% and we can quantifiably prove that. So at a high level, these are things going on within the project management group in 14.6. It's fast, it's good, and I'm excited about it. If you have any questions, feel free to ping me on an issue or check us out in the S_plan Slack channel. Until next time, ciao.